We are in our studio singing for the seniors' homes around Alberta and possibly into BC. So this is for you, all you beautiful old folks that have been shut in for a few months, maybe more, and we just want to lighten your day and your spirits. So bless you all.
For this opportunity to be able to share the message and just the gifts that you've given us to be able to bring forth a strong message of salvation, and that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we thank you for the company you bring into our midst. And we ask your blessing upon them and on all our notes and our words. And we love you and ask this in Jesus' precious name. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
He hath heard my voice and my supplications, because he hath inclined his ear unto me. Therefore will I call upon him as long as I live. And I think through this today, more and more people are calling upon him because they're losing hope. The sorrows of death compassed me, and the paths of hell gat hold upon me. I found trouble and sorrow. Then I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord, and righteous. Yea, our God is merciful. The Lord preserveth the simple. I was brought low, and he helped me. Return unto thy rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with me. And through that, I'm going to share a little bit later on what happened to me and how alcoholism was so close to ruining my life, totally. And I'm going to share that story a little bit later.
You have called us to
My name is Charles and I am 15.
This is Julia.
And this is Janessa.
She is 17.
Sorry.
18.
And she's 18.
We're twins.
My name is Lene and I'm 21.
My name is Amberlynn and I am 23.
My name is Brooklyn and my age is none of your business. And my name is Brianne and I am 28. And I am Brooklyn's twin sister.
And my name is Lynette. And I'm the blessed mother of all these beautiful children.
And my name is Bob and my wife is 54. Take it away, girl. to share a testimony, and it proves that miracles happen. October 18th, 1989, at 9 a.m. at Kenworth, where I was sales manager, I met the Holy Spirit in a bathroom, and I fell on my face and I accepted Him into my life. I repented of my sin, and you've got to realize that what led up to that, I was homeless, a drunk, and didn't even have a bed to sleep in. And sometimes that has to happen in order for you to come to Jesus. I knew about Jesus. I was raised in the Catholic Church, but I didn't and never was told about a personal commitment and the repentance of sin before my Lord and Savior. There's a lot of things in between that time that happened on that dirty bathroom floor. It mirrored my life. And when I looked into the mirror, God showed me a man that had no direction, had a very dark life. And when I fell on my face, He picked me up off the floor. And even to this day, I feel His arms around me. And He said, "I love you, Bob, and that I forgive you." And that very day, I was healed of alcoholism. I didn't have to go to bed seeing snakes come out of my stomach, snakes come in my windows, and snakes all over the roof of my bedroom. I slept like a baby that night. And ever since then, my conscience is clear. And as you can see around here tonight, that He never quits working as long as we're committed to walking with Him. I look at Him as His hand is out. And for each one of us, we have that choice to grab on. And He will take us through the swamps and through the dark times as we are going through. A lot of people now, there's so much hope in Yeshua Messiah, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
And I'm going to share something real touchy later on here too. So we'll move on.
This is a song that I wrote, I think it was last year. Actually 2 years ago. And I wrote it because I was contemplating the gospel and I wanted to understand it in even simpler terms. So I wrote this song, and it's an invitation to non-believers to come to Christ through repentance of their sins, and also a calling to the Church of Christ to stand up in boldness and boldness of the Holy Spirit, to take their faith seriously and to be unashamed of Yeshua.
God, you sent your Son to save the ones you have called to be your daughters and sons, all of those who believe and turn away from sin will be great.
Thank you.
except a corn of wheat falling to the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. He that loveth his life shall lose it, and he that hateth his life in this world shall keep it unto life eternal. If any man serve me, let him follow me. And where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. The Rose by Amanda.
Thank you. a song my sister Amber wrote for someone very special.
Very special. Thank you.
one that has spoken, every child, it come right from their heart.
Mm-hmm. Amber went around to all of us and she said, what would be the words that you would describe Mom as? If you had two or three words, what would be the main ones that you would choose to place on Mom? So that's how they got there.
Something else to share. So in 1989, October 18th, at 9 a.m. I got saved. A year after that, my father brought this beautiful girl into my life. And I had a real issue accepting this gift because I didn't feel that I was worthy until I heard his voice through my wife at Muskogee Park when we were walking on the trails and we sat on a bench and I told her my past and how I felt and that I didn't feel that I was worthy. And she looked at me with her big blue eyes and she said, Bob, you're born again. You are brand new. Everything that went on before I met Jesus. Nothing has ever been brought up about my past. It's the most beautiful thing. Anyway, a year after we were wed, then Bree and Brooke, we were blessed with a set of twins. And then I decided that was enough. And so I went in and had a vasectomy. Everybody knows what a vasectomy is, right? Just about all men get vasectomies today. So first, without consulting my father in heaven, without consulting my wife, she would pick up a baby and look at it, start tearing up, and then she'd look at me, and that still didn't hit home. And I was walking across the yard one day, and the Holy Spirit got a hold of my heart again and said, I thought you made a commitment to follow me and give me direction for you in your life. And you know, I was broken again. And I apologized to my father for, and he says to me, you have cut off all the blessings that I have for you.
Okay.
All these blessings. And I had, and I phoned my wife, I said, book me in for a reversal. And I went in, I was 42 years old, and I went in for a reversal. And the rest of these children are because of that decision that one man made that will affect many generations to come, that I never knew would happen. Everyone is a miracle. Everyone is a blessing. You receive them as a blessing, that's what they will be. You receive them as a curse, that's what they will be. So you see these beautiful children. At 42, we had 7 more children.
Wow.
Yeah. So I have to share that at every concert, and it's so... It's so alive.
Clean.
If I ask you one more time, away.
Ready? He will carry you, and he will carry you in these times that we're going through if you surrender to him. He will help you. He will carry you each and every day, many, many times a day. I know when I was first born again, the enemy attacked me. Oh. And I would, even though I didn't know my Bible, I knew I had a relationship and direction from him, and I loved him. And I would just say, in the name of Jesus, Satan, be gone. You have no authority here. And it would happen many, many, many times a day. And sometimes we just have to do that many times a day. Amen?
Amen.
There is no mountain to talk, he cannot move.
bless you all out there, and we're really praying and hoping that God just shows us a way to come and see you again soon.
Yes.
So just hang in there. Jesus wants a commitment from you. He wants your heart, not words. He wants your heart. So bless you all out there, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.